Hey guys, it's me, Savannah. I'm actually planning on not editing this video, and I kind of just want to talk to y'all for a second because this has kind of been something that I've been struggling with for a while, and I just kind of like, I don't know, I want to like share, see if y'all felt the same way. Maybe you haven't, but if you have, see if you have. And kind of like talk about it, I guess. I don't know. I highly doubt there's gonna be anything that y'all say that's gonna necessarily make me feel any better about the situation, or, you know, because I mean, it's not that I feel bad, but look, okay, anyways. What I wanna talk about, the validity, if that's even the correct term for how I'm feeling right now, the validity of my passions and what I do being not valid. So there isn't a lack of validity, there's a lack of validity in what I do in my passions, or feeling like there's a lack of validity in what I do and what my passions are. Okay, so if you're asking like, okay, what does that mean? Like validity in what I do and my passions. Like, I always thought what I did and the things that I like and like the types of YouTubers that I watch and videos that I watch and, you know, languages and all that, you know, I always thought that it was lame. And I would still do them. I mean, I still do languages. I study Spanish. I study Japanese. I have YouTubers in those languages that I watch. I like sewing. I like drawing. And even though I still in the past and still kind of sometimes feel like, you know, what I do is so freaking lame, you know, if it was really cool, I would get all this, you know, recognition for what I do, I guess. And because it's not one of those hobbies such as like beauty and makeup and dancing and stuff like that that gets a lot of attention, I would always feel like maybe just what I do isn't necessarily making enough impact. Like, if what I did actually made a difference in other people's lives, I would be able to see like that impact, that difference, that influence. And because what I do, the types of things I do are usually like really solitary types, solitary hobbies. Like, I don't necessarily need to post on YouTube. I don't need to have social media. I don't need to do any of those things in order to necessarily enjoy what I do, because fundamentally it's just like, it just kind of requires me, if anything, to talk to people like friends and like close relatives that speak the languages that I like. But other than that, it doesn't necessarily require any other like human interaction. You know, making YouTube videos and like showing beauty and makeup, that's very external. Like, it's for other people to see, and there's none of my hobbies really kind of go into that. But I wouldn't think about that. I would just see, oh, that hobby or rapping or whatever other hobby there is that's getting more attention is getting more attention, gets more recognition, gets more, you know, traffic. And because mine isn't, I don't really feel like, or I didn't really feel like my hobbies were good enough. And so when I mean the validity of what I do and my passions, I always felt like deep down inside that mine were just really lame and that I should probably just go find another thing that makes me happy, that does bring foot traffic, that does bring attention, that does bring praise and the type of social interaction that I would like on my channel or just in my life, whatever. And this kind of goes hand in hand with like self-confidence. Like, oh, I look at myself, and even though people say you're ugly because technically the society doesn't like noses like yours, you still gotta believe that you're beautiful, you know? And like, okay, so you learn that and it's like, okay, cool. So then it's kind of like transferring that same mindset to what you do and like what I do and what I like and what I'm passionate about. Like, even though, you know, I'm not shaking my ass and I'm not making eyeshadow tutorials and I'm not talking about my skincare routine all the time. And even though I don't have enough money to buy super expensive eyeshadow palettes as soon as they come out, or I'm not big enough or relevant enough to get them on pre-order and all this other stuff, and even though, you know, I don't have a lot of friends and I have a lot of followers and my channel, for example, doesn't get a lot of comments and everything, and just because, you know, I don't have a lot of social opportunities at school and I'm really deemed as introverted and antisocial for some reason and people think I'm aggressive and what I do is kind of not monetarily profitable, it's still beautiful, you know? Like, what I'm doing is still cool, and I shouldn't be, like, searching for other things to do as thinking that my, like, what I like isn't good enough, you know? Especially since when you want to look at, like, what makes an impact and, like, what makes something great or someone great, you know, the amount of people that tell you that this is great or the amount of people that are telling you that what you're doing is, like, worth something doesn't necessarily mean that it is worth something. It's more about the actual value of the situation that, to me, I really do think is measurable, like, quantifiable, qualitatively and quantitatively. Like, for example, you know, I may not have a million subscribers for YouTube example, because this is something that we can all kind of just look at, like, objectively, since you're watching this video. I may not have a million subscribers, but I might have, like, a tiny bit of subscribers that most of them are really, really, like, active and, like, watch my videos and actually like who I am. It's really, like, tight-knit community. So, I mean, you know, this is lower in numbers, but, like, the quality of the people that are watching my videos may be higher due to the, like, the close-knitness of the group that I have watching me, or the people who are the watching or affiliated with this hobby that I'm talking about all the time are very, or most likely, these sets of personalities that are really actually inspired by my videos. They're not just like, oh, I'm watching her because she's pretty, or I'm watching her because I like her lip color, so I clicked on the video. Like, you know what I mean? There's a lot more of, like, personality, nerdy substance that's involved in my small channel than I think there is that is involved in, like, the bigger channels. Not talking shit about anybody's channel, it's just, you know, you have to think about what necessarily makes people great or things great before you can sit there and judge it. And I was really focused on me making an impact and wanting to see that evidence of me making impact through numbers, whereas that's not necessarily where impact comes from. And so I feel like I'm kind of going on a tangent, kind of not going on a tangent. But I guess what I'm trying to say is that feeling validity through the wrong things, or, like, you can have good intentions and then end up searching for those good things through the wrong things. Because at the end of the day, I've never thought to myself, hey, I don't want to be myself. I don't think that I think that what I'm doing is a waste of time, because that's not how I would feel. I would wake up. I mean, I can study languages for hours, I can read in the languages, I have so much fun, it makes me so happy, I can do them all the time. I always search for opportunities to use the languages that I'm studying, like, it is a part of my life, it does make me happy, and I'm never, and have never, ran away from that. It's just that sometimes I'll be like, that, oh, I'm not good enough feeling, or this isn't good enough feeling, is, like, what I'm talking about. I understand that what I do isn't going to get a lot of views. What I do isn't necessarily clickbaity. This is a small community in the YouTube perspective, and in life perspective, it's just, I don't have a lot of friends. It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, what I do and how I am and what my personality calls for is just a smaller group of personas, people, and that's just something that I have to not get used to, but like accept. And I shouldn't be wishing that what I did was more, not recognizable, but I guess popular, because certain things are and certain things aren't, and just because it isn't doesn't mean that it isn't great, you know? Fame and the size of my audience doesn't make what I do great or not great, you know what I mean? It really is what exactly I'm doing and what exactly I'm accomplishing through what I do. And when I look at it that way, I'm like, man, you know, what I do, you know, I am pretty damn great, you know? I'm an education major, save the world, let's go, you know what I'm saying? But in terms of you, because I know I'm using me as like the focal point of this video, especially since it is about my feelings. I don't know if y'all have ever felt this way, and maybe the feeling could be a little bit complicated. Because once I start like putting it into words, I'm like, wow, like, what the f*** am I saying? But, I get so like confused or whatever. But I'm hoping that I made sense, and I'm really hoping that if you were feeling this way, that now you know that you're not alone, and that there is something, or there is a way to feel better about the situation, and that, you know, you're never gonna, maybe, I guess, never gonna feel 100%, like, just because you don't feel 100% the way you want to feel doesn't mean that you're not making progress. You know, because that's where I'm at right now. So, anyways, I just got off work, so that's why I kind of look a little rough. I'm like looking at myself in the viewfinder, like, what the heck? But I really hope that you enjoyed this video. And if you liked it, or you want more videos like this where I kind of don't end it and I kind of just talk to y'all, please let me know by liking this video or making a comment below about topics that you're interested in as well. And do not forget to subscribe. 最後まで見てくれて本当にありがとうございました。登録もお願いします。とりあえずまたね。バイバイ。